Howdy hon, welcome back to the channel. This is Stephsgotit. And we are about, to embark upon a whipping chat. Woo! So go ahead and take this time, if you haven't already, to go ahead and get your work in progress out. And let's go ahead and get it set up so that you can get some work done while we are chit-chatting along here. So this is Monday night, so we will be working on, my work in progress will be the Victoria Moon's Angel painting, which I am making pretty decent progress on considering I only get to do it once a week right now. I'm trying to balance a lot right now. So if you've got your workout, then let's go ahead and let's get it cracking. All right, just trying to get you within the shot. Okay, make sure you're in there clearly. I might come down just a tad bit. I have to take these big clips off. Come down just a bit and clip them back. All right, so as I say always at every beginning, I hope that you have had a great day and things are going well. It's Monday, so you know, you can never tell how Mondays are going to go. But it's also an opportunity for a fresh, brand new start. Let's see, what do we want here? We want some L's, I's, and 7's. I forgot to pack this back up. We're going to go ahead and put it away now. All right. So, this has been a Monday, I tell you. I was glad to see it come, and I'll be glad to see it go. There's a lot going on. This may be a short whipping chat because I did not get a chance to get some questions. I barely remembered that I had not shot this video yet and ran in here while my husband is prepping dinner. He is so awesome, so amazing, so everything. he went ahead and just was like, what do you want for dinner? Do you have any ideas for dinner? And I'm like, no, not yet. And he says, so will you eat whatever I cook? And I'm like, And I tell you, the reason for that is not ungratefulness, please understand. But my husband will cook at any time, no problem. Don't even have to ask him. If he just sees I'm tied up in something, he'll go ahead and just start cooking dinner. The thing is, he has very strange tastes. So he makes very strange combinations. He cooks with logic, and that doesn't always pan out. So that's why he asked me that question, and I kind of, okay. Because then whatever he comes out with, I have to go ahead and just eat that. And sometimes it's a hit, and sometimes it's a miss. So we will see. I'm going to go ahead and do L. We will see what it is tonight. And I'm the type of person where I don't like having to lie about whether I like something or not, because I'm a foodie. I genuinely enjoy food. And I love to eat. I love the flavors and the taste and the textures and all those things. So I'm generally not one of those people who are going to fluff you up with lies and tell you your food was good if it wasn't. I'm not the person that you want to let your little kid give their first thing that they've cooked to. Because I might be able to verbally lie and say, oh, it's wonderful. But my face, I didn't mean to put that in there, dagnabbit. My face is going to tell you what I really think. I'm not good at disguising my face when it comes to food because I love food so much and I don't, life is short. I don't like to waste it on bad food. So, so we have this thing. We don't have to lie to each other about whether something was good or not. It's not being mean or whatever. I have to let you know, because if I don't let you know, then you will continue to cook that dish and I will continue to hate it and be forced to eat it, and I don't want it. And I feel the same way. I don't want him to lie to me about something. Unfortunately, fortunately for me, my husband will eat anything. So he doesn't have very, even if something tastes bad, like I'll tell him all the time, life is too short. Don't eat that. Throw that away. Life is too short to eat food you don't like when you have the ability to eat foods that you do like. So anyway, that's why he asked me that, and that's why my response was that way. I remember the first time my niece by heart, who liked to cook, was cooking something, and her mom and dad was like, okay, you cannot tell her it's not good. I'm like, why? Because if I don't, she'll keep making it that way. But when she brought it out, I did my very best not to frown, not to make ugly faces. I think I was successful, if memory serves me correctly. That just popped right off and I have no clue where it went. I was able to go ahead and spare my niece's feelings. Let's see, let's get us a timer started here. We'll at least go for 30 minutes, if nothing else. Hello? Can we? Thank you. Let's see. Timer. We want to do 30 minutes at least. And then we'll make an adjustment at that point and see where. Come on, good grief. Can't be faster than that. There we go. Well, we'll give it 35 because I don't feel like holding it down to go back. All right. 35 minutes. Go. I said start. Okay. So, yeah. I love food, but I'm not going to waste my time eating something that I don't like unless I am starving and it may not be an opportunity for me to replace that food anytime soon. Or in the case of my, now I tasted it, but please believe I did not eat it. I tasted it, and if it is not good, I am not going to eat it. I'm just not. I care about you. I love you. But it's not the end of the world if somebody doesn't eat your dish. Life is too short, guys. I'm telling you. Life is too short to waste it doing things that make you unhappy. Now, I'm all about making other people happy. People happy. I am. That's why I did my best to tell her that the dish was okay, was edible. But I don't remember eating it. That doesn't mean that I didn't. I just don't remember eating it. And I don't want anybody to lie to me. I tell people all the time, like when we have the missionaries over for dinner, I tell them all the time, I am not a cook. Okay, if you don't like something I put on this table, do not give me that pleasantry crap. Just tell me you didn't like it. We will get rid of it, and you can have a sandwich, or you can have, if there's time to make something else, we can make something else. But, or you just eat the other dishes on the table that you do like. I am not going to force anybody to eat something that tastes horrible. If I cook it and it tastes horrible, I'm not going to eat it. So I'm certainly not going to force somebody else to eat it. And I tell people, quick, don't sit at my table with that politeness mess. Because if I invited you to dinner, it's because I like you and I like having you in my home. And I don't do that often. So trust, believe, if I invited you in, it's because I want you to relax. I want you to be yourself. I want you to feel open to say what you want to say, while being respectful, of course. But I don't want you to feel forced to do something that you don't want to do, to eat something you don't want to eat, drink something you don't want to drink. Tell me you don't like those things and I will replace them with something else. It's that simple for me. I don't see what the big deal is. Especially when you know your own limitations. It's no big deal for me. I like for people to come to my home and be comfortable. I like for them to be comfortable enough to kick their shoes off, put their feet up on the couch, lay on the couch, you know, just feel at home. And I don't like to have people in my house that make me uncomfortable. Because if I can't be comfortable anywhere else in this world, I am going to be comfortable within the walls of my own home. And if it ever gets to the point where you make me feel uncomfortable in my house, you have to go. There is no politeness. You have to go. I'm sorry. Not sorry. I think it's rude to try to make someone feel uncomfortable in their own home. And you're a visitor or a guest or whatever. I don't care if you're family, friends, whatever. You should never go to someone's home and try to make them feel like the outsider. That won't work here. So that's that. So he's in there, bless his heart, cooking something. I can smell something. I can't tell if it's burning or if it's supposed to smell that way because I don't know what it is. And he was asking me about hot sauce. A bottle of hot sauce that was in the refrigerator, and he said, "This looks really old." And I said, "Well, I can promise you, tell you that the older it is, the hotter it is, the darker in color it is. For Louisiana hot sauce, I don't know about any other, but I know Louisiana hot sauce, the older it is, the darker in color it is, therefore, the hotter it is." And he doesn't do hot, no. But after being married to me, he's getting there. He has a higher tolerance for hot than he did when we first got married. When we first got married, he would claim his lips were on fire if he... But with my son and I and our granddaughter, when she was here, we all ate hot sauce. Now, they eat really hot stuff. I have a little standard. They will eat anything hot. I like a little heat with a lot of flavor. I don't want to eat something just because it's hot and then I can't taste anything. That doesn't work for me. Now my son will do that. Our granddaughter did that. They ate like those hot Cheetos and things like that. I have to have some flavor. And for me, Louisiana provides a really nice flavor. And Tabasco does not. Therefore, I don't eat Tabasco sauce. And like I just, in my late 20s, started to eat fried okra. Fried gizzards mixed in. I mean, fried liver mixed in with fried gizzard. Chicken liver and gizzards. I still don't eat liver. I can't. I just can't. I can't. Once when I was, I don't know, fourth grade-ish, my mom did the typical southern dish of liver, I guess beef liver, and onions, which is a big tradition here in the South. It may be other places too, but I know in the South it's a big hit. And I just can't stand the smell. I cannot stand the smell of liver. It makes me nauseated. I think the texture of the meat is gross. When it hits my tongue, I want to puke. I can't eat it. I can't smell it. I can't eat it. And she and my mother was a very authoritative parent. So it wasn't like you could say you had, you know, no was an option. And, oh, well, I don't like dinner. I'm not going to eat it. That was not the type of family household I resided in. You ate what was cooked for dinner. And you better be thankful for it. And you certainly don't tell your mom, not my mom, what you aren't going to do in her house. And that has boiled down to me as well. You don't tell me what you're not going to do in my house. And if you don't like what I told you to do in my house, you're free to go out the same way you came in. That's how I grew up, and that's how I am, and I'm going to be that way. And I don't mind being that way, quite frankly, because it's just a matter of respect. You respect someone when you're in their home, and you live by the rules that they give you. If you don't like them, then by all means, get your own house and pay your own bills, and then you can do whatever you want to, right? So she put this plate in front of me, and I was like, I cannot and I will not eat that. I didn't say it in those words, I'm pretty sure, but I got my point across that I'm not going to eat that. And my mom was the typical response, you'll sit there until you eat it. 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. She made random checks. It was still there. So she's like, well, you'll just sit there until you eat it. And the last time she came in, I don't even remember now what time that was, but she came in and I had fallen asleep with my head on the plate or in the plate. I can't remember now. I must have been on the plate because I can't stand the smell of that stuff. So I can't imagine I would have put my head in the plate. Of course, once you fall asleep, I guess my head could have fallen into the plate. So, sorry about that. I had to cough and more phlegm was coming up. I'm still coughing and having phlegm come up. But, so she came in and she just burst into laughter that I was still sitting there refusing to eat this food, because she knew that, of course, I would never be disrespectful to her. So she just burst out laughing and she said, just go to bed. And I went to bed, and she never served me that dish again. And to this day, I cannot eat a piece of liver, like a piece of beef liver. Now, a friend of mine, years later, like I said, in my late 20s, did convince me to try chicken livers. Not just the liver by themselves, though. We would go to this little local quickie mart, and they would sell fried chicken gizzards, and then you could have them mix it, half chicken livers and half fried, you could order an order of chicken gizzards and then have them mix it with half fried chicken gizzards and half fried chicken livers. So half lizard, you could make an order for chicken gizzards and ask them to do half fried chicken gizzards and half of the order fried chicken livers. Whew, my goodness, that was hard to get out. So she got me to try that and then to dump some Louisiana hot sauce on it. And that began my journey with eating Louisiana hot sauce and with eating chicken livers, but I'll only eat it that way, fried and mixed in with the chicken gizzards. Like, you can't just give me an order of chicken liver. I'm not going to eat it. I'm going to need something to camouflage And the chicken liver, to me, wasn't as strong of a taste and smell as beef liver. So I think that's why I can tolerate it some. But it definitely has to be mixed with the gizzards. I can't just eat it by itself. It's not that small. And that began my love affair with Louisiana hot sauce. Which I don't even eat anymore, hardly. It's very rare that I eat it. I don't fry a lot of foods either, so maybe that's why I don't eat it as much. But I do have this awesome recipe that one of my coworkers shared with me for Louisiana chicken dip. Oh my goodness, it is so yummy. As a matter of fact, I'm going to make some for Valentine's Day. That stuff is so good. Comment down below if you're a fan of Louisiana hot sauce or any hot sauce. What's your favorite brand of hot sauce? And how long have you been eating hot sauce? Are you like my kids who started eating it young, even though I wasn't eating it, but their fathers and fathers' families were? Or were you like me who started eating it in your late adulthood? I'd be curious to know. Are you a Louisiana fan or a Tabasco sauce fan? Because to me, they are very different. And I don't like the Tabasco sauce. So comment below those two things. I'll be very interested to know. I also love hot wings. And I love to take butter and Louisiana hot sauce and make a sauce, a hot wing sauce. Oh my word, that is the best dish like ever. I love some hot wings. What I don't like are the atomic bombs and all that kind of stuff. I don't need my hot wings to be that hot. I need to be able to taste them. If I can't taste them, then what is the point? You know what I mean? I'm going to switch out this 3-placer for a 6-placer and hope that I can make the 6-placer play nice. Both these pins are from Jim's Handmade Pins. He has an Etsy store. You can find a link to these pins in the description box below. But it should also have the link to his store where you can just look around. And you may not like these water marble, but maybe there's something else he has that you may like. And that will get you at least to the store so that you can check it out. See, me and this 6-placer, me and these multi-placers are just not working. I'm barely able to use the 3-placer successfully. But anything bigger than that, I have not managed to have good success with. I need to try the 4 and the 5. Actually, I think I tried the 6 because I was trying to fill in a big area. And, yes, sir.
Oh, food.
The food's ready?
It's ready.
Okay, thank you. I'm scared, y'all. Oh, we gotta go see what he has prepared. Bless his heart. Actually, we need 15 more minutes just to get 30 minutes in. I do want to make it worth your while, but I do also want to taste it while it's hot. Chop it while it's hot. Yeah. So, what was I saying? Yeah, I don't like those atomic bombs. And what's the hottest thing you ever ate? We went to, you know, I love sushi. So my friend and I always go to sushi after her belly dance workout class. She teaches the class at the local college wellness center. And it's the same one that I sub at. And I sub that class, as a matter of fact, sometimes. But I love when she's teaching because I get to go be the student. I don't have to think, I just follow. So we will often go out for sushi afterwards. And one particular day, one of her students decided that she wanted to go with us, which I wasn't happy about. I was like, you know, this is my time. This is my time. Tell her to go another day. Because, you know, we usually talk and we have our private moments of, you know, things we discuss that we probably aren't going to discuss in front of someone else. And chance to vent safely in a safe environment and, you know, whatever. So, but anyway, the lady came and it was so funny. First of all, she didn't even know how to eat sushi. She didn't know what sushi really was, other than, you know, just what she heard. She had never really seen it or eaten it. So we had to take a moment for that to help her figure out what to eat. This lady got her plate, again, because she was not familiar with sushi, being in a sushi restaurant. She was not familiar what that little green stuff in the corner was. She thought it was avocado. So my friend and I are in the middle of a conversation and we're just talking away. And we're saying, you know, we're talking about as much as we can with someone else there listening. And this lady picked up that entire little mound of what is it? Wasabi sauce? The green sauce, I think that's what it is, wasabi. I always forget what it is because what the name is, because I never eat it, never touch it. This lady picked up the entire little scoop and put it in her mouth. And she began to perspire and cough. And we're like, what the heck is wrong with you? And I looked at her plate and I thought, oh my gosh, did you put that whole stack of wasabi sauce in your mouth? And she's like, no, I ate the avocado. I'm like, lady, that is not avocado. She started to get just coughing, slobbering. And the lady brought her water. Then they brought her bread. They brought her something. They were bringing her all these things to try to help her. Now, while it was over, I was really kind of cracking up. While it was happening, I was really kind of cracking up that she had done that. Usually, you just taste things that are on your plate at a restaurant you've never been before. You don't just pick up a whole stack of something and put it in your mouth. So, I kind of was mean. I was kind of snickering, but I wasn't snickering so she could see me. But I was snickering nonetheless. And after a while, when they gave her everything they possibly could to help her, my friend kind of started snickering a little bit too. After a while, when everything finally calmed down and she could finally, I don't think she ever truly got the feeling back at that dinner, but she was able to talk about it. And once we were able to talk about it with her, we fell out laughing. That was like the cue to say, okay, it's safe. You can laugh now. And we were laughing and cracking jokes. And it was hilarious. And I don't understand why people intentionally do that to themselves. Eating ghost peppers and eating all these hot ingredients to see. I mean, I've seen people literally just slobbering like a baby teething on YouTube eating these things. Why would you do this to yourself? I don't understand. I don't know why there's even things like ghost peppers. Who can eat that? But, you know, and there are some people who can eat it and that's fine. But for the people who are just torturing themselves for a YouTube video, I don't understand you. I don't understand why you would do that to yourself. I don't need views that bad. I don't care how many views I would get or subscribers. I am not going to eat something hot just to get a subscriber. I'm not going to do it. But to each his own. Everybody, you know, some people are more adventurous than others. I would have to be more adventurous in another way. It won't be that way. But yeah, but it was hilarious. I told her, I wanted to say, well, see, that's what happens when you intrude upon my time, but I wasn't that mean. But it was quite hilarious. I wouldn't wish that on anybody, because my friend, the one who was with us, now she likes hot stuff. She likes the wasabi sauce. She will take a little bit and put it on each piece of sushi. And she'll be eating it and crying because it's so hot. And she'll be like, oh, excuse me. Oh, oh, it's so hot. Oh, it's so good. Oh, it's so good. I was like, I don't understand that. There is nothing good about crying about something being hot in your mouth. I don't see how that could possibly be so good that you're sitting here crying. I mean, tears coming down her face crying. And yet she's steady slapping it on. Just steady eating it. Pew, pew. I can't even dab my finger and just get a little grain of it. And I'm on fire. So I really don't like that stuff. I don't need that much heat on my food. I like to taste my food. And I always wonder, do people who really like that stuff, like my friend, can she really taste the food? Or are you just tasting that hot sauce? Well, wasabi sauce. Anyway, to each his own. Let's see. What else has been going on? I'm excited about tomorrow, because tomorrow I get to teach this church that I teach Zumba at and any other fitness class. They have a class that they have dubbed the track class. And what it is a class where we go upstairs on the track. There's a track up there, and there's a little exercise room, and there are also some exercise bikes and 4 or 5 other little pieces of equipment up there. So we go up there and we teach whatever fitness exercises, and we throw in the track. Like, I might warm up walking around the track at a regular pace and then have them maybe speed walk around, and then we'll go in the room and we might do a couple of circuits of weights, and then I might put them back on the track again and have them walk around the track while doing bicep curls one time. The next time, maybe weights over their heads and doing triceps or something. And I may bring them back into the room and have them do stability ball. And we might do some, bouncing around on the stability ball around the world, pelvic tilts and posterior and anterior tilts. And we might do pikes and whatever. We'll just do a couple of circuits on the stability ball. Then we'll go back out to the track, and I might have them on the sides of the track do squats all the way down, and on the ends of the track do high knee ups all the way around. So we call it, they call it a track class, because we incorporate whatever we're doing, we incorporate the track into it. So anyway, I get to do whatever fitness I want. And that's why I love that class. I love the opportunities for those classes, because I get out of the Zumba mindset and work on some actual physical fitness stuff. And I love doing that. It also gives me a chance to work on with my yoga. And I always end with yoga in those classes. And so I love that. I do stability balls, medicine balls, weights, the stretchy bands, the bands that go on your legs, poles, what else? steps, and I might even throw in the bike, but generally I don't because they're not really bike. This group isn't like really big on big lovers of the bike. So, but it's fun. I get to play whatever kind of music I want. I don't have to follow a rule about the type of music, the sticking to a percentage of music. I can play any music I want to. It's just a lot of fun. I like it. And I like to push myself as well as push my students to do more than we've done all week or whatever. So it's a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to that. And I might call this a night, guys. It looks like we have all of the L's. As I say that, I spot one. I know there's three somewhere. That's why I got the three placer. But once I got the three placer, I couldn't find it again. Isn't that how it always is? You could check these things 50 times and then go to another color. And as soon as you pick up the first one of the other color, you see one or two or three of the color that you just put back. It never ceases to amaze me how you could go over it so many times going one by one and still miss it. There's the three right there. Ta-da! Cool. Alright. I got to do my first live Facebook Live of my mascara later after it had posted. So I guess I'm so used to doing these hour-long whipping chats that I don't know how to do a short video. So I definitely have to have a timer when I do my Facebook Lives because I definitely do not want them to be any longer than 15 minutes. Or if I'm doing a 5-minute makeup face, then I definitely want it to be 5 minutes. So they can see how easy it is to do it. But I was so tickled when I went back and saw that 55 freaking minutes for a 5-minute makeup face. And then when I get on the whipping chat, I can't last. Of course, I was explaining to them and showing them, telling them what I was doing, how to do it and things like that. So I guess that helped to give me more things to talk about. I'm actually surprised today that I've had as many subjects roll off my tongue as I have because I did not get a chance to print notes like I said I would. It just didn't work out that way. But it's okay because we're doing okay. And since I've got a meal that's probably cold right now, I need to... Oh, my mother could not stand that. When she cooked a meal, when she was done cooking, she expected you to be at the table ready to be served. She could not stand to cook something and call everybody to the table and people don't come. That was like a pet peeve of hers. Luckily, my husband and I don't have that because... Sometimes we take the second to finish what we're doing just because it will be harder to come back to it after we've sat there and eaten and talked or whatever. So it's just nice to kind of finish off what you started. Now sometimes my husband will just get up and leave whatever it is if he's at that point. Actually, most of the times he will. I'm the one who, well, just let me finish this one little thing, this one video, this one that. So I'm going to go ahead. Oh, wait, there's an L. I think I have all the L's now. And I think we've been talking for, well, I know we've been talking at least 30 minutes, hopefully at least 45 minutes by the time we're done editing. So I'm going to go ahead and sign off for tonight. And I want to thank you for taking the opportunity to join me tonight and for stopping by the channel. I really appreciate your support. And again, this is the Angel I've been working on for Victoria's Moon. I'm almost halfway there. And it is our Monday night whipping chat with my cat. And, oh, yes, thank you. So I'm going to go ahead and say, if you are not a subscriber, let me please encourage you to click that subscribe button below and the notification bell so you can be notified anytime that I upload a video. And you know you can choose what to be notified of in your notification, with your notification bell, in case you didn't know that. You can choose which videos or which whatever you want to be notified of on any channel, not just this one. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like this video, you're always free to give it a thumbs down. You do you, boo, right? Let's see. I think we have said all of the preliminaries and we will go ahead. Well, it's not actually a preliminary, is it? It's at the end. But we will go ahead and close this video with my with the tagline or the advice or the statement that I always do, whatever you want to call it. If you are having a good day, help someone else have a good day. It's those small and simple things in life that makes it all worth living. Love and shimmies, hon.